Hello, everyone. I am here speaking to an empty room, but I figured I would record this because I had some important information to share with you about the upcoming assignment. So hopefully you guys look at this video back to help you with the upcoming assignment. So the first thing that I wanted to do was review last week's assignments, which was the crisis management plan and the what would you do scenario. I just want to give kudos to everyone. You guys did a great job with your presentations on a crisis management plan. For those of you who did your presentation with audio, thank you so much. Instructors really appreciate that. So just as a hint, if you guys, you know, have other classes that give you the option of doing that, I highly recommend you do it. There are some really great ones. There are lots of different types of cyber attack reports that you guys did. It ranged from cyber attacks in general to phishing attacks, malware, social media awareness, staying secure while working from home, cyber attacks on mobile devices. So just a wide range of different topics that were used, which was really great. The graphics were great. I liked how some of you provided a slide showing an example of a phishing email, pointing out what areas to look for. So if you were presenting this to, you know, employees in an organization who didn't have much knowledge about this, the visuals helped tremendously. Some of you related a virus to an actual flu, which I thought was brilliant because it puts that in such layman terms for anyone to understand. So when you talk about viruses on your computer, sometimes you assume that people know what it is you're talking about, but you might be surprised that not that many do. So relating it to something outside of cybersecurity was a brilliant, brilliant idea. Someone pointed out that posting pictures of where you are online is not a great idea. And, you know, thank you for that information. I never thought about that. You know, you're on vacation and you're posting pictures and, you know, somebody could be knowing you and knowing that you're not at your home could make you more vulnerable. Someone mentioned the quizzes that are on social media. You know, what's your birthstone tell you about yourself and how you have to be cautious of the quizzes and whether or not they're legitimate on social media. And then someone pointed out the importance of not ignoring the updates when you get notifications on your computer. And I'm notorious for doing that. Shame on me. But how you should do it. Great simple point that could avoid, you know, many cybersecurity hacks and viruses and so forth. And then some of you provided some statistics, which is always a great thing to do on a slide and then talk about it, right? You know, number of phishing attacks that occurred in a particular industry or whatever your presentation may be. So overall, you guys did a great job with that. I'll skip down to the what would you do discussion board. And another great job, and the majority of the class stated that you would shut down all of your systems. So of course I went back and I looked at what your responses were from the Twitter hack, and there were only two people in the class that said that Twitter, you know, shouldn't have shut down. But then when it came to this past week's discussion board, they said shut down. So I just thought that was an interesting point, that if it was an outside company, how your perception of things can change. All right, so I'm going to talk about the assignments that are due this week. The first is the discussion board. It's going to be a what if scenario. You're going to be given three scenarios. You have to respond to one. And basically, it's asking for, you know, how would you respond? And most importantly, what type of communication would you use? Would you use an email? Would you give an in-person meeting, you know, with your staff members? Would you put out a press release, so forth and so on? So you have to only choose one of the three scenarios. The first is there's going to be a travel ban to a country where you have employees. So you need to notify employees of how this is going to work. So how would you communicate to that to them, and what mode of communication would you use? Then the second option is you want to make an announcement on the company's COVID policy, and the same there. How would you do that, and what would it state? There are resources in the module, like the CDC website, of where you can go. And then the third option for the what if scenario is there's a video with Elon Musk and the Tesla debut of the shatterproof windows, which turned into a debacle. So the what if scenario is, so if you were Elon Musk, what would you do? How would you respond? You know, would you write a letter to your customers? Would you write a letter to your stakeholders? Would you have an in-person meeting with your staff? There are a lot of people that you'd have to include and to try to rectify what went wrong. So that's for the discussion board. So most importantly, the employee handbook this week. So you're writing an employee handbook for your company that operates in the US and the country that you chose in your environmental scan. So some rules and policies may differ because it's a different country. So you're going to have a cover page. You want to include on your cover page, you know, the effective date and of this employee handbook, as well as the last time that it's been updated. Next, you want to follow with general information, the purpose of the handbook, and an equal opportunity employment statement. The next section will be policies and procedures. You're going to talk about the Americans with Disabilities Act, sexual harassment, and FMLA, Family Medical Leave Act, right? So these apply to the US. So you will have to do some research to see if the country that you selected in your environmental scan have legal policies in place for these policies and procedures, and make sure that you give a write-up about both. If they're the same, make sure that you let me know that it's the same. This policy in this company handbook, this applies to Germany and US employees. So when you submit your paper, well, let me get to the third part. So then it's going to be, you have to come up with policies and procedures based on your specialization. So if you're a cyber specialist, you want to write about a policy on procedures regarding each employee's responsibility for protecting the company's IT systems to lessen the threat of cyber attacks, right? So, you know, rules for email encryption, accessing work applications remotely, things of that nature, right? So you wanna have that section just on that. If you're an IT specialist, you wanna write about the company's policies and procedures on company computers, you know, using the internet at work for personal reasons, what's the protocol for passwords, what's the policy on installing personal software on a company computer, right? So this is your company that you're writing the employee handbook for, so you come up with your ideas on what you want the policies and procedures to be. If you're a data analysis specialist, you wanna write about how the data, how personnel data is used from the company, you know, how it's shared, what is it used for? Is it used for payroll? Is it used for performance evaluations, emergency contact information, right? So you want to have a section on that. And if you're an administrative management specialist, you want to write about HR policies. It could be, you know, disciplinary actions, vacations and holidays. And again, you want to make sure that holidays in the US may differ in the country that you chose in your environmental scan. So you want to make sure that you include the policies and procedures for both countries. This is going to go through Turnitin. You're probably going to get a high score with Turnitin. That's expected because when you talk about the Americans with Disabilities Act, sexual harassment, and FMLA, these are laws, right? And even if you, so your country, your selected country has laws, you're quoting laws, right? So you're not going to be able to put much of it into your own words. But, you know, you want to insert your company name, you know, ABC Company abides by the U.S., you know, the Americans with Disabilities Act or something of that nature. So in that part of your paper, I'm expecting to see a high level of relevant scores with your Turnitin. But when it gets to the policies and procedures that you have to make up based on your specialization, I don't want to see a lot of relatable items with your Turnitin score on that section, right? So there's 25 points associated for this paper on your specialization policies and procedures, right? If you have a really high score and I can see the details, and if I see that your policies and procedures based on your specialization is really high, you run the risk of getting 25 points taken off of the paper, which doesn't leave room for anything else being wrong. So while I understand there'll be some level of matches with Turnitin because you're citing laws, the final section, make it your own as much as possible. So I hope this helps you guys and wish you could have joined me, but that's okay. I hope that this information helps you getting through the assignments. Have a good evening and good luck, everyone. Bye.